sleep at the wall? Where do you want me to sleep at the wall?
And can you protect, can you cover up when someone enters the door?
Hey, now that's funny. It's okay. It's okay. Let's assume you can actually go sleep.
Sometimes we are sleeping and sleep. No, you, okay, sleep. You always want to sleep everywhere.
Sleep. Who has refused? And push up.
Anne.
What?
I've been thinking.
Stop there. You thinking. New one. Mm-hmm. What were you thinking?
We need another baby.
What do you mean? They don't pick children on the road. Already we are suffering with the child that we have.
Are they suffering how now? Okay, this is a girl. Maybe we will do a boy, it can be better.
Because you are God, that when I get pregnant, you will be sure that it is a boy.
No, we can't figure out how we do it.
As if we are finding it, we hardly pay this girl's school fees by the end of the term. And you want us to get another one?
No, we shall manage.
Stop saying we. Stop speaking French here. I'm not French.
But we're family.
I'm not there. Don't we mean?
If I don't have you, pay.
No, that's not how it works, Jared. I'm already having trouble. Every time this girl gets out of the gate, I am expecting her to come back pregnant. Now you just want to double the trouble. So that on top of having a pregnant embarrassment, I get a thief also. Because any son of yours wouldn't be.
But how would you start calling a kid who is not yet even out?
And you seeing the one we have here? Problems, her shaking bums, going to church, her doing homework of art with boys. You think I'm not seeing what's going on? Please.
It's just a baby.
It's not just a baby. It's a process. It's not just a process of conception. There are 9 months there where me, the short black girl, I'm the one carrying that child for 9 months.
I'll support
me how? Carry me on your head. You cannot carry yourself. I don't know. You're here pregnant.
You carry them. I'll support you. Jared, finance.
Please, don't just come up with things that have no planning. Already we are struggling as it is.
And I am. Just a baby. I'm just
it's a baby. Not just a baby. I thought we were going to say we are going to shift. I need us to talk. Maybe we can go to a bigger place. And I think we should talk. Finally, I want to take you to church and we wait. And I said, you want another child? As if you're doing wonders and miracles. You know, as a matter of fact, I'm sorry. Why am I raising my voice when it's time to go to bed? Forgive me, Jared. What you are going to do? You go, I've given you permission. Find another person. Let them give birth for you. It's all right. It's okay. It's okay. You go and find another person. I've given you permission. What's wrong with you? Don't you want to tell children?
And let me be serious also.
I dare you, touch me again. Touch me again to Anne also. Nonsense. Good night.
Just don't mess with Kansime.
Let me hope to damn not early. You cannot be early. Let me tell you something. Hey. There are people who wake up first thing in the morning and they come here to take a few shots of something before they head to work. So you can never be too early. Anything you want is ready.
The usual.
All right.
Thank you. And it's room temperature?
Room temperature. Why? Excuse me? What's that?
But madam, I have my own opener.
So what if you have your own opener? This is a conspiracy to get me fired. And I've been seeing you, Nina, the way you're frequenting my bar. You're not someone who is wishing me well. It's not like you're here because you want my bar to thrive. You are waiting for a day my boss chases me away from this place and you come and work here. I've been seeing you because there are hidden cameras here. You want her to see you open with your opener from your bag, and then they think I stole all the openers in there. But did I tell you I didn't have an opener? Don't I have an opener? Isn't this an opener?
It is, but I guess what it is.
So when you go to church,
You carry your own bread just in case the Holy Communion bread is not enough. That's, you want to tell me that that's how self-contained you are? I have my own opener. Actually, like, let me check your
there
bag.
Is nothing.
You might have alcohol in this
there
bag.
Is nothing.
No, please. By the time you want to carry your own opener, who knows, you've come with a mobile toilet, a potty here. So you don't even need our toilet. No, please, aren't we lucky that there is a counter here? If there was no counter, wouldn't you have dived straight into the fridge? Would you be on the third drink right now? You can't be patient. Like, you badly can't wait to... Can't you just be patient? You're that much of a drunkard.
It's okay, you open now.
Hey, of course. And it's not like... You can't...
Kasime, please, can you please open that
photo? Please, don't make me panic. I've been doing this for how long?
But it's
for about 6 years. It's a profession. I went to school and learned these things. Aren't you? You just see things, people opening. If I open this bottle at a terrific speed of lightning, the cracks of the grass can fall inside and you end up making me give you another beer. So please, calm down. Let me do my job. And you're not going to make me panic. You're supposed to hold the opener at an angle.
Kansima, are you opening the bottle or not?
I don't think you should.
It's okay. Take your drink. I also don't want it. Go.
And you think it will expire? Oh, by any chance, no one else will buy. As a matter of fact, I can afford to open and drink it myself and pay.
Just don't mess with Kansime. Just don't mess with Kansime.
That song of the guys used to do. Woohoo, tell him when you are good and black at
Excuse me, please. Hmm? Have they told you we don't have music in this bar or what? Who has hired you to come and become a nuisance in my band, create a choir, as if we don't have good, sweet music that other customers have been listening to? You're shushing me. Do you know me? Do you know that this bar is mine? It is mine. And you're not the first people to be happy here. We've seen people who are happy. And when a person is happy in a bar, they don't behave like teenage gorillas that have seen tourists holding bananas. And you just make a nuisance, a fool of yourself. You think these people are depressed? People get happy in different ways.
So what?
You're not the first person to be happy in this bar. And you're not going to come here and make it difficult and start polluting the air and make it difficult for other people to have fun when they've paid their money. Yeah? This is nonsense. This is utter and absolute nonsense. But we are happy. You're not the first ones. We've seen people who get happy and they slap their friends because their fingers are itching. Others get happy and they cry tears of joy. All these people, they decided to be happy and act the way they want to act. Do you know what would be happening? People would think we have a mental hospital in this bar. I'm happy. If you are happy, you say drinks are on the house. That's how people be happy in the bar. You don't be happy and start making a fool of yourself. Tip me. Tip the one person who has served you until you are happy. Or make it, you say beer, everything, drinks on the house. Then we know that you are happy. But if you have nothing to do, please don't do it here. If you have a choir to start, go somewhere else where they might need your services. We are happy. You're not the first person to be happy here.
This is tough.
Just don't mess with Kansime.
Kansim.
What?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes. Kansim.
What? What is it?
Where are you coming from?
Unless you have time, I don't know where to start from. Yesterday, when I left this place, I stood by the side of the road. Do you know taxis were looking at me as if my money is counterfeit, like they're allergic to me? None of them stopped. So I decided to start walking.
Yeah, but because
and you will not believe it. We went for the funeral. We went for Gwendire's funeral first. When we were at the funeral, didn't come Zinga, Evelyn get Nanka, Reba pains. So we thought, we said, should we call the husband? Or we just do this ourselves as Mother's Union. So we carried her, took her to hospital. Do you know that woman was in labor for 17 hours? 17 hours still pushing. First the hair, first the fingers, first that kid. I don't know, that kid is going to just be an athlete. So afterwards, you see now the way the hospital is made, this particular side, it is proof. It's like waterproof. Then this side, the lifts, there are lifts. Eh? Then they have steps like in the. So the maternity ward is on the second floor. Then up, it's the cancer section. But down here, it's like there are mad people that be there. So the hospital was very disorganized. Then I sat down and said, eh? Ah, so labor pains ended like at about 6 a.m. Then I said, eh, let me just walk home. I started to walk. Then I realized I was walking very fast. I was going to be home and end up coming like at 5 to wake you up.
But you can see me. You left here saying you're going to the market.
Exactly my point. All those things that happened, I didn't plan them. You think I killed someone so I had to go for a burial? Eh? Or you think I'm the one who impregnated Kemizinga so that she gets labor pains at the burial? Am I the one? No, it's me trying to be friends. I'm trying to be there.
You left here saying you're going to the market.
Yes, and plans changed. They changed. Why are you suspect? Where do you think I slept, Jared? Where did you sleep? Actually, as a matter of fact, I think because now it's like you're guilty and you're trying to bounce it off on me. Where did you sleep?
Councilman, don't change things.
Where did you
sleep? I'm not bouncing anything. It is just me asking. You left going to the market.
Just to know I ended up in hospital. Seated next to Eva with her bouncing baby of 4 kilograms. I don't know who pushes 4 kilograms.
You know, Councilman, me, I'm going to work. Someone brought your bag, apparently left it in Kubi's bar.
Yeah. Now that you've talked about Kubi's bar, so afterwards, after I was walking home, do you know that Kubi's bar has a happy hour between 1 a.m. and 4 a.m.? Those people are selfish. How do you put happy hour in the middle of the night? Can you imagine? So we had to go there, drink beer. Then I forced life. Then I said, let me just leave it and just come home. I had missed you. Do you know that at Kubi's, happy hour is between 1 a.m. and 4 a.m.? From 1 to 4, who puts happy hour in the middle of the night like that? So I sat down, I said, let me reduce on the speed with which I'm approaching home so that I don't wake up my sweet husband. All these things I do them for you, Gerard. Everything I do in life is all for you. I do it for you. Good night.
Just don't mess with Kansime.